You've made it past the initial rounds of the interview process, and now you just heard that you've gotten to the Super Day, the final round of the interview. There's 20 other candidates, 3 spots. How do you stand out from the rest? In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to master the Super Day, specifically for investment banking, but a lot of these tips can apply to final round interviews overall. And let's start off with tip number 1, and that is to be likable. Easier said than done, but I'll share with you guys a few tricks on exactly how to do that. The person who answers every single question perfectly, but shows no personality, will likely not get the offer, while the person who answers every question reasonably well and gets along super well with the interviewer will. So when your interviewer is talking to you, you want to show them that you're engaged in the conversation. When they're talking, nod your head, show that you're listening and taking in what they're saying, respond back to them. It needs to be much more like a conversation rather than just answer and reply. You don't want to seem like a robot, you want to seem like a human and someone they actually want to work with, because at the end of the day, they're hiring someone who's likely going to be working with them, well, not only in the firm, but potentially within their own team too. And if you're not the lacrosse player who graduated from UPenn Wharton with a 4.0 GPA, have a reason for why they should hire you over them. And I'm sure an offer will likely be in your future. Number 2 tip, it is to be confident. It's so simple, yet so difficult. It's extremely hard to pull off because obviously you'd be nervous for a final round interview, who wouldn't be? But one way to calm those nerves is to be extremely well-versed in your answers. One thing people say is that if you know your technicals and your behaviorals too well, you end up sounding robotic, but if you know them even better than that, that's when you start to sound natural. Know your technicals and your behaviorals well enough so that you can be more relaxed during the interview and come across as more confident. Two really great resources that I highly recommend for doing this are 1, the 400 Question Investment Banking Guide. It covers both behaviorals and technicals. I'll include the link to that file down in the description box below. And beyond that, I've talked about them several times, but Financial Edge is an incredibly good resource for studying investment banking and showing your interviewer that you are well-versed and that you've got your technicals covered. Financial Edge is used by the top 4 investment banks to train their incoming full-time analysts and associates. They offer an investment banking course on their website, so you can learn exactly what these incoming full-timers are learning as well, right from your own home. On top of that, they even offer a certificate at the end of the course so you can put on your resume, and it can even be a discussion point during your interview because a lot of bankers do recognize the name since this is a program that is actually taught within the investment bank for incoming full-timers. Link to that will be in my description box below. If you use my code, you will also get 25% off. Number 3, the best interviews aren't the ones where you're going back and forth on what a DCF is or why you're a great team player. The best interviews are the ones where you end up talking for 20 minutes about your shared interest in playing tennis, your love for making fresh pasta. It's the things that are on that last line of your resume called interests that can really turn the tides on a super day. To get you into the mind of your interviewer on a final round interview, think of it like this. It's generally someone who is more senior, usually a managing director or executive director, and this person is really busy. They've got a lot of client meetings, they have to have meetings with their own teams, and they'll likely have perhaps around 4 to 6 interviews throughout the whole day, likely stacked together, but between that, they might be doing a client call right before, they might have had a team meeting, so their mind is scattered and on a lot of different things. So, what they're going to remember from a conversation isn't how well you answered why you're a good team player, it's how good of a conversation they had with you overall. Yes, it matters how good you answer those questions, but you only have to answer them reasonably well that it doesn't raise any red flags. What you do have to do though is come across as an interesting and genuine person. If you're naturally someone who is affable, friendly, transparent, just be yourself. What actually happens on super days is that everyone who is an interviewer will gather in a room, have one big call or conference meeting together, in which they are going to decide and talk about each of the candidates one by one. So what you want for you is to have a good enough conversation with someone where they say, oh, I really like this person. I think that they'd be a great fit for the firm. I had a great conversation with them. And then you want someone else to follow up with that and say, yes, I really like them too, had a great conversation. Because after someone already says that they had a good chat with you, it's unlikely that someone is going to go against it unless you had a very big red flag in your interview. And next thing you know, you are on the top of the offer list. Obviously, you still need to answer every question decently well, but that's not what's going to get you the offer at the end of the day. Number four is to know your news. People oftentimes miss this and only study their behaviorals and your technicals and then stumble when they're asked about what they're following in the news lately. You must understand that for final rounds, you're generally interviewing with people who are more senior, and these are people who have been in the industry for decades. They don't care about trivial accounting questions. The assumption is that you've already been vetted for all of those things prior to talking to them. However, what they will be impressed by is your knowledge of current events, because that's not something that everyone knows, and that's something that can set you apart. These people read the newspaper every morning. They're caught up with the financial news because these are things that they need to talk to their clients about. One really great way to get your financial news intake is through a newsletter called The Daily Upside. Founder had actually worked a decade in investment banking in New York City before he started this newsletter, so you know it's going to be incredibly relevant to whatever your interviewer might be asking you. The Daily Upside is a business newsletter that curates impactful and insightful financial news. And by signing up for their newsletter, it's an incredibly easy way to get interesting, relevant, and digestible news straight to you every single day. I don't have any upcoming investment banking interviews, and I'm still signed up for the newsletter purely because it's very interesting news, and it's a great way to stay up to date. The newsletter is also 100% free, and you can sign up for it in literally a couple of seconds. I will include a link to that one in my description box below as well. Go check it out. And number five, what they care about during the super day is that you are a good fit. So show them that. When you're asked a question, tell me about yourself, you should be answering why you're there today, why you're interested in investment banking, or whatever the job role is, and you should not need the interviewer to ask you an additional follow-up question. Why are you interested in investment banking? You should have answered it from the get-go. This question would have likely came up in your prior round interviews as well, but it's especially important during the final round. At this point, you've already been vetted for your credentials, your technicals, your behaviorals, and they're trying to see if you would be a good culture fit. That different firms have their own unique cultures, so you really want to know what makes a specific firm unique. JP Morgan might seem similar to Bank of America since they're both global bulge bracket banks, but they definitely have their own unique differences too. One good way to find out more about this is to talk to people at the firm. You can either ask your previous interviewers through the first, second, third round what they find unique about this firm and then use their answers in the super day. Or you can also coffee chat with people and talk to them on the phone and ask them, current employers, what they find unique as well. Then you can use those same answers with the managing director in your super day, and they will be incredibly impressed that you can name all these specific things and that you've already talked to all of these people. Those are my five tips for getting an offer from the final round interview. If you found this video helpful, it would help me a ton if you gave this a thumbs up. And if you're not already subscribed, subscribe down below. Turn on notifications so you'll know whenever I post a new video. And if you want more personalized advice from me and more of a community, check out my Patreon. I offer tons of questions geared towards interviewing as well as one-on-one consulting sessions on there. So check it out at patreon.com/angelasunx3. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!